Cushioned Hall is located in the Glens of Antrim. We're hemmed in by mountains behind us and sea in front of us, so it's kept the place so tight-knit, and our geographical location has probably hardened us and made us a wee bit more resilient. Here's my first senior manager, Fergus McAllister Skinner. He would have brought me onto the senior team many moons ago. A bit of a character, a bit of a local legend. This corner shop here, a sweet shop, was my grandfather's shop. Jim Hamill's, probably in the 1930s and 40s. Now in a different family now. So it is. Hurling means everything to this village, you know. It's the lifeblood of this community.
We used to have the teams up in the window there in years gone by before mobile phones and all that sort of crack. If you want to know anything about the club, you just came here. And we sold them some meat as well.
From Neil was about 5 years old, hurling was always his first love.
The local hurling club was only a few minutes walk. Neil was always an ultra competitive youngster. He had great levels of enthusiasm and aggression.
As a young boy, he was very friendly with Shane McNaughton, who was the son of Sambo McNaughton. Well, Sambo's a very infectious person, and anybody that he associates himself with, he wants him to play hurling.
Because those guys had come before him and had worn that jersey with such distinction, I think that was something that Neil always really wanted to do.
We wouldn't need anybody in the likes of Tip or Kilkenny or Cork to teach us a love for the game. The ball's been passed to Neil and his generation, and they got to pass it on. It's not a question of will they must do that, they must pass that on. I would say he's the best Ulster hurler present day, but like, and it's not by accident.
I remember in 1999, after a county final, and I remember patting Connor McCambridge and Kieran McCambridge, two brothers, two class players, on the back as they were coming off, and I couldn't believe the sweat in their jerseys, the big thick cotton jerseys. You know, it's one of those images. I was only, you know, I was probably only 8 or 9 years of age. I remember coming home and just thinking that, like, he was one step down from God. You know,
this is actually a scrapbook that I've made for Neil when he was 21. They had a very successful Antrim minor team. Neil was one of the stars of the show then. He's so determined, he's so passionate, he's exactly what you would want, I suppose, in somebody that you're going to marry. There's a lot of children, they're always looking in to see Neil. Great to see them coming up with their hurls, and they're chomping at the bit to try and get out and be playing.
The young people who are here, they want to be playing for Cushendall and for Antrim in the future too. We're a coastal community. Our links to the sea are, they've been here for hundreds of years. And, you know, after games or training or something, you know, the whole team will come down to one of the two slipways here in Cushendall, and we're lucky to have it on our doorstep, really, you know. It beats an ice bath every day of the week. Clears the head, maybe, if you didn't win, you know, you're kind of refreshed and recharged and ready to go again.
For a long time, Antrim were able to compete at the very top of the Allianz League, and I believe success for me and my career would be bringing Antrim back into that top tier of hurling and leaving it there for the next generation to come on, you know, build on that.
He's the one player who a lot of the younger fellas would look to believe them, and when he's on form, you know, then the rest hopefully will follow, and that's what we look from Neil for every match.
No matter what part of the pitch he's on, you'll hear him, like, and that's, it's a great thing. He's a great encourager, you know, and he does, he lifts players.
Good touch, Ryan.
I absolutely love the training. You know, that's the bit I think I'll miss most. Whenever we're all working hard and the rain and the snow, and it bonds a team, the world against us, you know. Goal. Hurling is a sport like no other. It's dominated my life, and it's a huge part of this area, you know, in the Glens of Antrim, and long may that continue.